As you heard, the foundation came out of the vision of the Japanese community. And to me, it was inspiring to learn about the history around it, because when reconciliation efforts with the Japanese community began, they realized quickly that if we were going to fight the kinds of racism that that community was exposed to, it would take a whole country to come together. And so they made it as part of their negotiation that the money that was being offered as redress would come together to fight racism, not just against their community, but in the interest of all Canadians. And it's with that spirit that I work and am proud to be part of the foundation. And the important part of what we do is dialogue. And I think, to use my couple of minutes here, I would want to emphasize that that's why I see the importance of these surveys, and that's why we were part of it. Keith mentioned it. We work with various partners to continue that dialogue, whether it's doing surveys or doing programming that is informed by what we learn from these kinds of research opportunities. And what we learn is that we need to know each other. In order to counter racism, what we need to do is find a way to know each other in a real way. And I would point, I left out some of the surveys that we've done, but each year we try to commission something we call Pulse of the Nations. And we did one in March 2016 with the Institute, the Canadian Institute for Identities and Migration, Jack Jedwab, who's doing a lot of work in this area as well. And that study, and I left some copies of it, but you're welcome to visit our website, actually gives a somewhat contrasting view at certain points, although Keith helped us understand the relationship between the two studies. And mainly in this study, we asked non-Muslims what they thought about other Muslim, about other communities, including Muslims. And for example, there had been a drop in positive views of how Muslims were viewed amongst Anglophones in 2002, between 2012 rather, in 2014. But when we revisited in 2016, we saw we returned to the original level, but still there was a negative opinion, less than 50%. It ranged, but we were falling under 50%. Similar negative opinions about other communities, and you're welcome to take a look at the study. I certainly am going to be running out of time here to go into it. But it tells us that we have concerns about relationships, we should have concerns about relationships from one community to another. And certainly the survey and the data that Keith is showing to you, I think, should spur us on, if nothing else, is to try to reach out and understand us. This study that I cite, the March 2016, asks the question of how much contact do we have with each other, with Aboriginal community, the Muslim community, the Jewish community, depending on which community you belong to. And the numbers are typically well under 50% of people saying they have a contact with another community. I think that emphasizes to me how important organizations like the IDI, like the Canadian Race Relations Foundation is if we're going to counter negative attitudes, then we have to come together to have those dialogues. As I close, I also invite you to look at a 2014 study that we put together called Keith made mention of it, Report on Canadian Values, where we ask Canadians what are the values that they see, how in a sense of a list of priorities. And the study that we did here reflects pretty well the types of numbers that we've got there. But one of the aspects that I wanted to highlight is that we ask people how do they identify with religion. And while it's low, those that are identifying religion as an important part of themselves are also identifying that they find it it's a barrier to integrating into society. When we ask Canadians what they thought about certain religious practices and how it related to multiculturalism, sort of the opposite side of the question. People saw it as a negative factor to integrating. And when we asked what kinds of religious practices are you concerned about, you can imagine things that came up, and such as the hijab, praying in public, and so forth. Again, put it all together, and I think the one of the key points that I keep learning is that if we're really going to fight racism, if we're going to build inclusion and understanding, then dialogue is, and this is one exercise on that important road that we just got to keep on. Thank you very much.